this opportunity truly, truly is something that is historic. So if you don't know about the internet computer, it is, in my opinion, one of the most, if not the most advanced blockchains in the world, not just from the perspective of cryptography, but from the perspective of speed and storage. And it basically leverages the computer, I would say, processing power, truly decentralized all around the world. No Amazon Web Service, none of these other things. To be a compute provider, you actually have to go through a very rigorous process, right, with Infinity. So it is, in my opinion, the most decentralized internet, sorry, the most decentralized blockchain out there. So again, I'm excited about the technology. I'm excited about what we're building. Definity is the governance organization for the internet computer. That makes sense, right? So we have you have the internet computer, which is the blockchain. That's the technology. You have ICP, which is token, right? Just like you have Ethereum blockchain, Ethereum token. And then you have the Definity Foundation, which is sort of the umbrella, which is the organization around that. And also what really has me excited about this project is, look at who the investors are. Look at who's been funding the technology. Everybody from Andreessen Horowitz on down. So you really have the biggest names. And came into this about sometime in July, where I had been talking to the Definity team for a while. The CEO Dominic Williams, who is just a genius cryptographer, is someone that we've been on each other's radars for some time. Dom said, "Hey, I like your writing. Do you want to do this?" So I'm helping build this thing out right now. And we're just getting started. I mean, if you look at the technology, it's still, I would say, raw. That's no knock on the dev team. It's just we're in the beginning process of standing this up, but we wanted to get started. So a lot of cool things will be coming down the road later in terms of user interface, in terms of all that. Is it Ethereum killer? I mean, even recently when they asked Vitalik Buterin about, are there other blockchains that you're scared of or make you nervous? I don't remember what the exact question was. He mentioned the internet computer. One of the reasons is that you would pay millions of dollars to store something on, to store something on Ethereum, to store something on Solana that you would pay $5 for on the internet computer, right? So you have this idea of canisters. I don't want to get too much into it. Almost think of canisters acting as sort of a microservice, as microservice actors, and being able to host smart contracts in that. Now, without getting too much into the technology, I can tell you that you have storage costs massively cheaper. You have much less latency. If there are benchmarks out there, you can check them out for yourself. But the whole issue, and I'm going to come back to it, is that most of the blockchains, they run on Amazon Web Service, they run on AWS, they run on Google servers. That's not really decentralized, is it? So the internet computer model is a little bit different, where the node providers are actually, like I said, fully vetted. There's a whole governance model around it. There's a whole DAO around it. There's a whole staking model around it. It is complicated, I'll be honest. It took a lot of PhDs to come up with this technology. with this whole paradigm, and these are people. I think I just heard Definity slash internet computer has the highest number of ex Google engineers working for them right now than any other company in Europe. Now, again, I can't completely, you can fact check that. I can't completely verify it, but that's what I've been hearing. So here's an interesting use case, and I'm gonna touch on. So we've talked a little bit about the decentralized aspect of it. We talked about the speed and the storage, which I'm not gonna get into to too much detail. Other than one thing is that in the canisters, you're allowed to store, I think, up to four gigs in each canister, right? But it is think of it as an in-memory database, right? So there's no real need to even go out and write to a normal database. You need to spin up more database memory. You can hash that out. So the whole model of persistence is something that they call, I think they call orthogonal persistence, is completely revolutionary. And these are brilliant cryptographers that have thought this up. What I like about the internet computer specifically, now I'm just starting to get into it, this concept around what they call the internet computer identity, right? And if you have any experience with edge computing, if you work in, or conceptually, is they edge computing. You know how we sort of go from client mainframe to client server to cloud, and we just keep going in a circle of where we're going to push the computing power. Edge computing pushes the processing power back more to the device level. What ICP has done is they've given the option to push a lot of the cryptography back to the device level. So I literally can log in with my fingerprint. When I logged in today to the computer, I just logged in biometrically. I didn't have to worry about a seed phrase. I didn't have to worry about any of that, because somehow, and again, I don't know how they do this, is that they're using the chip in my iMac, they're using the chip in my my iPhone, where they've actually pushed the cryptography and that whole security process, the biometric authorization process, to my device, right? So it's being, you know, it's being pushed to the device level. It's a much more secure way to do things. Because look, in the future, if you follow the news with the Binance deepfake the other day, the future, even conversations like this or Zoom calls, we're all going to have to sort of verify that it was really us before or after, probably biometrically, right? So we need a better way to distribute and promulgate our personal identity throughout whatever ecosystems that we're going to be using. And I don't want to bore you with details, but dig a little bit into the internet computer IC identity, and you'll be, I think, really, really amazed at the developments that are happening right now and the technology that is available. One other use case is, so I had a friend recently that was, not only was their MetaMask wallet compromised, so it's one thing to go to a site and click on a bad link and all of a sudden what happens? Your wallet is drained, right? Well, your wallet is drained, the damage is done. But if your seed phrase is compromised, your whole, the whole lineage of everything that you've ever done is compromised. This particular person is an NFT artist, and they have NFTs that are on the market, and you know, he has these NFTs that have sold that he's in line to get future royalties. Well, guess what? Those royalties are now going back to his wallet that has been compromised. And there's no way around him. And that while that, so it's not like you can, I mean, you know, he could go to OpenSea and start burning all his NFTs, but oh, that's going to cost gas to do that. And if he puts Ethereum in because he wants to pay the gas to burn the NFTs he has not sold, that money could be extracted before he even gets to do that. So there are certain things, if you look at what you have to do with MetaMask, what you have to do with some of these other, you know, on-chain wallet solutions, there's just a better way forward. And for me, ICP, with what they're doing with the internet identity, really, really is just a better way. It's a better way of doing things, better way of doing business. The tech is just better.